Hey guys, Paul here from FamilyWheels.ca. Thanks for tuning in to another car review for Canadian families. Today on the program, I'm actually taking a little bit of inspiration from Twitter because I asked my Twitter followers recently, okay, what do you think the ultimate family vehicle is? And David Lendrum got in touch to say, I have to say, with three kids, lots of gear, my Ford F-150 can't be beat. For cost, capability, and huge space for kids, it's 10 out of 10. All right, David, I'll take up your challenge. In fact, this is going to be a really good test this week because I'm on my way on a 1,200 kilometer road trip to meet up with my family who have already flown out to the family cabin. We're going to see how this truck stacks up. And you know what? The F-150 has become exceptionally popular. In fact, it's the best-selling pickup truck in North America. This new version for 2015 has really upped the ante, and it's checked off all the boxes that are important to pickup truck owners. Better fuel economy, better comfort, better towing capacity, better payload in the box, lighter weight all told. But let's put it through its paces, see how in fact it does do with some of our standardized tests that we do on all of our Family Wheels tests, and see if, David, you are in fact correct that this F-150 is the ultimate family vehicle. Well, welcome to summertime in Western Canada. I'm on the Trans-Canada Highway and stuck in a sea of RV traffic, but hey, I kind of expected that going in. But it's a perfect time for us to talk about the new F-150 and what makes it so different. Hard to believe that this truck has been with us for 13 generations now, but this new version is so different that its production facility in Dearborn, Michigan had to be entirely stripped and cleared out, and new equipment had to be brought in. That's largely because this truck now, for the first time ever in a production pickup truck, has a body that's almost entirely made of aluminum. It means that this truck is on a 700-pound diet and that's really improved fuel economy. Last week on the program, I was telling you about the new GMC Canyon that's been redesigned for 2015. Fantastic little truck. However, even though this is a much larger vehicle, the fuel economy in the F-150 is actually better. Ford is saying that when it's coupled up with the 2.7-liter EcoBoost that I'm in today, that you should be seeing around 9 liters per 100 kilometers on the highway and about 12 and a half in the city. To be honest with you, I'm not really seeing those numbers myself, and that's largely because the EcoBoost engine does have a turbo in it. And whenever you've got a turbo, particularly in a big, heavy vehicle like this, it is still fairly weighty. It means that whenever you're leaving a stop sign or passing somebody on the highway, that the turbo will give you that extra bit of juice. However, it is going to dip into fuel economy quite a lot. I'm not driving this very hard, yet even still here on the highway, I'm only getting about 11 and a half liters per 100 kilometers on the highway. You can get this in four different engine types, everything from this EcoBoost to a 5-liter non-turbo V8. But the amazing thing about this little EcoBoost is you'd kind of think to yourself, 2.7 liters, are you serious? That's puny, that's not gonna do anything. This is a very capable truck. Has an 8,400 pound towing capacity. On the highway, it has a fantastic get up and go. And if you didn't open up the hood on this truck and look in and see that tiny little 2.7 liter, you'd never know that that kind of engine was running a truck this big so well. So really, personally, I love this little EcoBoost. Just have to be careful with how hard you drive it because those fuel economy numbers will tank. Here we are in the beautiful Rocky Mountains, partway through my road trip now, and I thought it was the perfect time to go through some of our standardized tests. First up is the trunk test, and obviously we've got a pickup truck, so it's not going to be an issue at all. You can get the F-150 in 5.5-foot to 8-foot box lengths, depending on the model that you choose. And this is another option that you can have on the F-150 that I thought was really cool. You can double tap this button right here on the fob, and the tailgate lowers on its own. Something little, but kind of cool. And it's also great because this tailgate is actually much heavier than I expected it to be, much heavier than some of its competition. Oh, yeah. And I spent so much of this Ford is built with aluminum, I was expecting that to be a little bit lighter. Now, when you look on the inside, this is an option. You can get it sprayed direct in the from the factory. It's a $550 option, but something that's well worthwhile. And if we look over here, another option that's kind of cool is this rear step up. You click on it right here, and that slides out, and it means accessing things at the back of the box is going to be much easier for you. That's a $300 option. Now, come over here, and I want to look at the rear seat with you, because this is the part that really blew my mind. I've put our rear-facing child seat in place, which soak up a ton of room, and what's that going to do for legroom up front? Well, this is the Super Crew model with 43 inches of rear leg room, and that means we have over 15 inches of leg room for the front passenger. In fact, I've maxed out the seat here, and there's still enough room for that rear facing child seat. That is crazy. I've never seen anything like that before. And in fact, to put that into perspective, the Mercedes S-Class, which is their high-end, almost sort of limo-like vehicle, has only 43 inches. This has 43 and a half inches of rear legroom. You can get it in the Super Cab as well, which gives you 33 inches, which is still pretty reasonable. But this Super Crew is incredible, and it means that you've got a ton of room in terms of rear cargo as well. You can see I've loaded all of our road trip gear in there, and there's still room to spare. Now, one thing that's really great is that when the seats fold up like this, it's entirely flat. There's no hump in the middle of the vehicle anymore, and that means that you can put tools, bikes, you can even put a dog bed back there and have your dog riding in comfort. So some fantastic features with this Super Crew option of the F-150. Well, you step up into the driver's seat on the F-150, and it's a really nice vehicle to drive. The suspension's been nicely tuned. Here I am today on the windy highways of British Columbia, and it's really sticking to the road very nicely. Not like some of the other pickup trucks that kind of bob and weave their way, you know, rather cumbersomely through the corners. This feels tight. I did take it onto some side roads earlier, some gravel roads, and the potholes and bumps and ruts certainly were felt. It's not super comfortable in that kind of environment. However, let's be honest, most of the time, we're going to be on highways, on city streets, and this has been tuned beautifully for that. One thing that did surprise me for urban driving was the turning radius on this truck isn't particularly good. It's quite wide, which means that if you're trying to pull a U-ey in a tight urban parking lot or something like that, it might be a little bit tricky. Looking at this cabin in general, here we are in the Lariat today, and it's fantastic. I mean, here I've got air-conditioned seats, a leather-stitched dashboard. There's a full 110-volt outlet that I could use just for charging tools, using a laptop, whatever, just like I was at home. I like that, and I like the digital display right in front of me here as well. Everything from fuel economy numbers, whether that turbo is kicking in and maybe affecting my fuel economy a little bit, trailering information, even navigation right here in front of me, which means I'm not always having to draw my eye to the central entertainment system, which does have some things that I'm not crazy about. When you actually go to use the touch screen, it's not quite sensitive enough. It means that I'm having to really jam my finger on the screen like two or three times for it to actually get what I'm trying to do. Then, if I try and use the voice recognition software here on the steering wheel, it's not quite there either. I tried to call my wife earlier, and it actually had me dialing an old high school friend. I tried to use the navigation system and navigate somewhere with voice recognition, and it sent me to somewhere in Quebec. So yeah, a bit of work to do there still, in my opinion. Look at the storage capacity in this cabin. It's fantastic. All these little nooks and crannies where you can put stuff. Tons of cup holders, tons of storage in the doors, on the dash, in the central console. I mean, you open this up, I could practically fit the family dog in there, and it all makes good sense. A couple of things that I'm not crazy about are these hard plastic surfaces around the dash, and this weird kind of mood lighting that's built into the around the cup holders and into the door panels, and it doesn't really serve a purpose. I don't get why it's there, and to me, it kind of cheapens the feel of the truck a little bit. Okay, so here we are on a random strip of highway, middle of British Columbia, and I wanted to play a little game with you to prove a point. There's an F-150, okay, we're gonna count that one. Because I wanna see how many we can spot in the next 30 seconds. So we've got one already, and here we go. In this little motel parking lot, there's another one, that's an old one. That one's been around for a while. Scintillating programming, isn't it? But it's gonna prove a point here. There's another one, that's a 90s one. There's another one, that's five and six. I see six F-150s in less than 30 seconds. Not exactly the most original of vehicle choice, is it? But you know what? It's a fantastic truck that has really proven itself over the years. Add to that here this year with the new 2015 version, top safety marks from the IIHS, the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. It's considered a top safety book from that organization. And you've got a safe truck that's a fantastic family hauler. David is absolutely right. If you put a canopy on the back of this, you'd have a safe, dry place for all the gear you can imagine, hockey bags, to strollers, wherever your family is at that point in life. In the second row, if you go with the Super Crew option, your family is going to be cruising in limo-like comfort. And then up here in the driver's seat, it feels like a quiet, comfortable sedan. So a lot of really good things going for it. And now that I've made it out here to the family cabin, you can add a couple of extra things to that as well. Great towing vehicle. That little 2.7 liter EcoBoost is more than willing to haul around my in-laws' rather large boat, especially when you put it into T mode down here on the gear shift. T equals towing mode and makes this truck more than capable. It changes the throttle response, the transmission response. This truck is totally happy to haul around a big boat all day long. S mode, which is also right down here on the gear shift, equals sport. And most of the time, sport mode, let's be honest, it's there for looks. It really doesn't do much at all. But here we have a sport mode that turns this into a muscle car as well. It just becomes a beast, and that little EcoBoost growls with joy when you turn it into sport mode. Doesn't do a lot for fuel economy, but makes this truck a lot of fun to drive. So thank you, David. A really great suggestion, a great all-rounder, really, in this new F-150. If you have an idea for what you think the ultimate family car is, then let me know on Twitter like David did. I'm at Family Wheels. You can always find me online, familywheels.ca. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll talk with you in the next review next week.